Welcome to our last Cedar Hall lockdown assembly on Wednesday the 15th of July. My name's Nick Maxwell, I'm the head teacher at Cedar Hall. I walked into school last week and the first person I met was Mrs. Hull. And her words to me were, "Mr. Maxwell, you need to get a haircut." And so if my hair's a mess, I apologise, and that's coming from a hairdresser. So before we start the Golden Book, I wanted to reiterate some of the things that were said in the letter that you should have received via email today. So to start with, the first day back for staff is Wednesday the 2nd of September, and primary and middle will now return on Monday the 7th. Not secondary, just primary and middle, and the idea behind that is to give those younger pupils, and many of them new to the school, the opportunity of induction. The following day, Tuesday the 8th of September, secondary as well as primary and middle will return. Our priority is to ensure that all the children, families and staff are kept as safe as possible whilst trying to provide a broad and balanced curriculum. And to do that, we will be doing the following things, and these are in line with the government's guidelines. So, cleaning hands. You might think, well, washing hands, we've been hearing this for months and months, but it remains a really important tool in stopping the virus. So pupils will wash hands at least 6 times a day. On arrival, before break, after break, before lunch, after lunch, and before going home, and of course, after using the toilet. Can't overemphasize how important that will be to keep us all safe. The catch it, bin it, kill it, we all know what that's about. That respiratory hygiene, as it's called, will be emphasised. There will be enhanced cleaning throughout the day. So cleaning will happen not just at the end of the day, but throughout the day. And we're all responsible for that. But there will be specific staff who will be cleaning all the surfaces that are most commonly used. And those who are unwell will be looked after in a separate room, and parents will be asked to pick up, so to try and minimise contact with others. We will be, like all schools, using the bubble system. That's groups of children that will be together, work together, play together, and eat together without being in contact with others in other groups, in other bubbles. And we will try and minimize the amount of movement of pupils around the school. So staff will be coming to your lessons rather than you moving around constantly from room to room. There will be one-way systems in some parts of the school, and there will be separate entrance and exit points for the different bubbles in the school. As far as transport's concerned, the taxis will arrive and leave at the same time as they always have done, but there will be a slight staggering of those pupils who arrive independently, whose parents bring them in. And the details of all this will be coming to you shortly. On the transport, face coverings for secondary age pupils who are able to have face coverings will be expected. And all this will take some time to get used to, but I'm sure, I'm confident that we will all learn as a community how to work together and be patient with one another and learn how to continue to socially distance as much as possible. So that's just a brief overview of the plans for September. As I say, there will be more information coming via email shortly, and it will be posted on the website. So without further ado, let's go to the Golden Book. And I just wanted to show you a picture of the ramp outside ML class. So that's now finished and is looking lovely. I'm sure Mr. Lazelle and his team will be extremely happy for that. The building work in the main part of the school is going on well. I'm meeting every 2 weeks with the builders to ensure that they stay on track. So let's look at the Golden Book for the final time this term. So Mrs. Klimek has put in all of Red Class for trying so hard during these challenging times. Lovely to see you all on Zoom. Mrs. Overall has said all of Green Class for taking part in the transition Zoom meetings. Well done to all of you. And she's also mentioned a special mention to James, Tom, Anastasia, Thomas, Johan, Cooper, Millie, Chloe and Teddy for keeping busy and working hard during lockdown and sending work to Mrs. Overall. So you will get those lovely certificates next term. In yellow class, Thomas, for good listening skills on the Zoom call that he had with Mrs. Philpott and Mrs. Mills. Yellow class, well, you're all your names are on that star somewhere. So well done and keep shining. That's from Mrs. Young. Well done to Flynn and Rohan for being so sensible and helping Mrs. Philpott and Mrs. Mills welcome the new pupils to MP in their Zoom meeting. So they had a Zoom meeting welcoming the new pupils, and Flynn and Rohan were a great ambassador. Now, happy birthday to Abby. She was 13. On the 2nd of May. What a gorgeous little girl. What a lovely picture of you there, Abby. Congratulations. And Mrs. Fielder wants to say well done to Abby for your amazing skills of looking after Roxy the dog and Jessie the cat. Right, I know Edward is a keen footballer, but what I didn't know that he's actually a very good cook. And here he is cooking a cake. The first part is just the mixture, then it's cooked, and then finally it's looks like some coconut on the top there and some jam maybe. Looks absolutely delicious. And he's done some research into the red tractor kite mark. So well done, Edward. Annabelle in Tempe is kept busy over lockdown, and here are some of the things that she's been busy doing: spellings, making things, and art and craft, and those stones looking great. Well done, Annabelle, for working hard. In Tempe also, you've got Liam, Theo, Sharon, Elliot, Emma, and Ashley for having a great Zoom meeting with Mrs. Mills and Mrs. Viewers. And they say it was lovely to see you all. Well done to Kane and Lewis in GB class, who've worked really hard during lockdown. Now, Mrs. Stabs wants to say a huge thank you to Harry in GB class for his generosity in donating his train set to the school. And we have a model railway club that meet in the building room, in the construction room, and Harry's kindly donated that train of Thomas. Thank you, Harry. Now, Connor has been doing some work experience with Mr. Crane, and he's been building a bench, and you can see how hard he's worked. So the bench is just made out of pallets, and he's worked really hard at that. And then they did some cooking, some tasty chicken chow mein, that looks like, and I think they shared it with the others who were in school that day. So well done to Connor, and the finished product, doesn't that look amazing? So well done. Mr. Crane was extremely happy with how hard you worked. Now, I said last week that some people were at Fellowship Afloat. So Fellowship Afloat is a big ship in Tollesbury, and we go every year, and lockdown wasn't going to stop us going this year. So instead of going for the week, we had day trips, and they were all socially distancing and keeping in line with the government guidelines. And so here we have Elliot, Luke and Sunny. I think that was the Friday. And there we've got Grace and Mrs. Fielder on the ship, getting ready to go out on a smaller boat. And there's Mr. Irvin and Mr. Brandle, all geared up, ready to go. Out of the way, Mr. Brandle, we can't see where you're going. Look, there might be rocks ahead. You never know, but you can't keep Mr. Brandle down, can you? And Miss Stone always likes to be in the limelight. Beautiful Miss Stone. There we go. She had her photograph taken as well. So here are some, not everyone was able to be well, for some reason I haven't got photographs of everyone, but it's lovely to see those of you who did have your photographs, how much fun you were having. So well done to Emily there, to Penny, to Kyle, and to Caden. And on another day, you've got Carl, you've got Samuel, you've got James, and Stevie all had a lovely time. And there's Faye. They also had some time on the playground, and I think the playground had only just been open that week, so they had some great fun on the playground, on the recreational area of at Tollesbury. And you can't actually see it very well, but actually Luke is steering the boat there, And that's Grace steering the boat. And it looks like you're having great fun there. I wonder whether you're doing donuts, going round and round in circles, Grace. It looks like everyone's enjoying you driving. And here, look, here Elliot looks like he's a very professional pilot of the boat. So well done to Elliot. You almost look like a member of the Fellowship Afloat staff there. So I'm glad everyone had great fun, and we look forward to going back to Fellowship Afloat next July. I've already booked the week. So finally, the Charles Carwick Helpfulness Trophy, and that this week, and the last week, the last winner of the year is Connor Perfect for his hard work in making that seating area. So well done, Connor. Well, have a fabulous summer, everyone. We look forward to seeing you in September. Just to say that the holiday club that Mrs. Hoy is running with her team will be happening starting the week after next for 2 weeks. So if you're involved in that, hope you enjoy that and have a safe time. So stay safe and healthy, and we look forward to seeing everyone in September. Thank you for your patience with us, and thank you for your patience and for all the encouragement that parents and pupils have given us. I'll show you a little present that I got, strawberry jam from Ethan from his farm shop. But I'm sure I talk on behalf of all the staff to say thank you for the notes, encouragements, and little prezzies that have come our way. So signing off for this year, and look forward to seeing you in September.